I first became aware of the Sable Trail Pipeline about a year and a half ago when survey markers showed up near the Withlacoochee River, near where I live in Hamilton County. I have learned a lot about natural gas pipelines since then. After much effort and personal expense, a small group of us were successful in convincing Sable Trail and FERC to move the route away from the northern Withlacoochee River in Florida. At that time, I was very relieved and believed that right had prevailed. However, as time has gone by, I realize that the same fragile limestone geology and springs that were at risk from the pipeline on the Withlacoochee River are still at risk at the other river crossings. People like me have stood up in front of you and reminded you that the citizens in these counties that the pipeline will go through will get no benefit from this pipeline, and yet they are the ones that will bear the consequences of water and spring degradation, explosions, and sinkholes that the pipeline is likely to cause. The people who live in south of Orlando and in the Crystal River area will get more electricity by burning the methane gas carried in this pipeline. We as Americans already consume more energy per person than most, if not all, other countries. Our leaders should not be encouraging more energy use, but rather conservation and clean renewable sources of energy. As you know, this pipeline is huge. It's 3 feet in diameter. It will be passing through an area in Florida known as the Springs Heartland. It will be passing through the area where our Floridan aquifer is considered to be the most vulnerable to contamination. It will pass under our outstanding Florida waters, the Suwannee and Santa Fe Rivers. Experts from the United States Environmental Protection Agency, the Florida Department of Environmental Protection, and the Suwannee River Water Management District have all stated that this area should be avoided by the pipeline. But it seems to have fallen on deaf ears and seems to still be slated to cut through this very environmentally sensitive and fragile area. I can only conclude that the reason it is still going through this area is that the pipeline and power companies have enough money and political clout to influence the political decision makers to ignore the public's opposition and our genuine concern and proceed with this project. Someone has got to stand up for the earth and for clean water. That is what I'm trying to do. We can't continue to exploit our resources and pollute our waters for the sake of profits and consumption. Please find the courage within yourselves to stand up for what is right. I'm challenging you to use whatever power you have to get this pipeline stopped. Thank you for your time and attention.